That's definitely a bear track, right?
That's like a cub track.
Yeah.
Cool. Are we gonna walk into the bait now?
Yeah.
Okay, let's go. How does it look?
Thank you.
It's a cool looking bear. See, his ears are rounded, eh?
I know.
And his snout is so light. Right, I'm here hunting once again. It's warm out. The bait's hit good. Jay and I just filled it up. I don't have that on video. It's completely empty. It's been 9 days since I've baited up the spot. It's insane. So hopefully it's only been empty a day or two and the bears will still keep coming in. There's a lot of black poo, a lot of black scat. So that tells me the bears, either they're new bears or it's bears that have hit the green and now they're back on the bait. There were two bears that came in while we were baiting. One was Big Mouth that Kira passed up. I think he would square like 6'2" because Kira's bear squared 6 feet. He's just a bit bigger than her bear. So I don't know what else to say. It's just my standard spring bear hunt. You guys come along. I'm not quite sure how I'm going to edit this up. I think I'm just going to show you as I walk in what the bait site looks like. All the barrels should be standing. There's probably going to be a couple bears there. With that, it's prime time here in Manitoba, May 19th. Man, this has been a good day, at least for me, for twice. I've shot big bears in 2015 and 2017 on the same day. So I have high hopes, but I'm a little bit concerned because the bait was empty. There was a little bit of corn on the ground, but I've shot bears off empty barrels. Skinny Rye has as well. I'm sure Jay has as well. So there is hope. Jay thinks I'm gonna shoot a big one. I think Jay's gonna shoot a big one, he always does. His will probably be bigger than mine. It will probably be like a blondish white. Probably a polar bear, actually. We'll probably shoot a polar bear today. So, not knowing what else to say, let's just get at this and see what the hunt looks like. Sit back, relax, and enjoy. Okay guys, there's a paw trail right here. I'm not gonna walk there. Because I don't want the bear to smell right where I walked. But that looks like a good one. There's a big bear here. Yeah. Pumped. Good to see a giant today. He has a hurt foot. He has a hurt foot. Thank you. All right. This is my third day sitting for myself. Last time I was here, the bait was completely empty, as you guys have seen. It's been a couple days, actually, since that hunt. So there's still quite a bit of bait left, as to be expected. I'm just hoping that the big bears are moving today. I'd expect them to move about 7:30 to 9 o'clock. That seems to be the best time, from my experience. It's going to change whichever location that you're in. There was a brown bear on the bait when I got here. I'm pretty sure I saw him last time, and in the field walking in there was a little bear. He didn't see me until kind of the last minute there, last second. So basically I just gotta sit here, be confident. The wind isn't great. It's a little off, but when Noah shot his booner there and Jay, that epic evening, you guys should see that video if you haven't. It's crazy, two booners in one evening, an hour apart I think as well. That it was the same wind direction and it was just a bit off. So who knows, maybe that's what the big bears like. They like having just the wind to their advantage, which would make sense. All right, enough chatting. Let's get to hunting. And I'll try and show you everything that I see within reason. Hopefully I see something. Hopefully I see a big one. All right. Just all scattered. Thank you. Wasn't meant to be. Big bear coming in. Maybe not. Same one from last night or the night before.
Mm-hmm.
Got him. Got him. I just got a gorilla bear. Well, I guess I don't have to whisper because that bear is down. I barely got it in video. He was just, no, that bear was just toying with me for about an hour. And I zoomed in hoping to get a better, like a nice close shot of him when I got him, but his head was just out and you can see maybe a bit far forward, but you don't have to shoot bears in the middle because that bear ran like, say, 50 yards and he's down with the Grim Reaper 3-blade Pro Series. And the first kill in the Revolt X. So I'm gonna get down, look at him, and then come in the morning and skin him out and take some good pictures solo. All right, let's go check him out. All right, it's the next morning after I shot that bear. It's been a cold morning. I think it was 4 degrees when I woke up, so I got some time. You can see the sun is just barely poking out of the smoke. Where is it? See? It's all blurred out. It's all white. But so the picture should turn out, and I used the Grim Reaper broadhead, so I want to show you the blood trail as well. It was good. I could follow it in the low light as well. Got my McDonald's here. So let's go. I'm rambling here. So there's blood, as you can see. It's good. You can see where he disturbed the leaves too. So if you don't have blood when you're trailing, look for any disturbed earth. And I can already see the bear from here. And there's the bait site. I would say, from the bait site he went, I guess I could step it out, I'm going to say 50 yards, less than 50 yards. So there's more blood up here too. So these Grim Reapers, first time using them, super impressed. And then there's a bear through there. I'm going to get them ready for picks, and that's where I'll leave you at that. I took them with, I just want to say a few things actually about the equipment. I'm not sponsored by anybody except Black Bear Remedies. If you want quality skincare products made out of bear fat, check out Black Bear Remedies at blackbearremedies.com. Good stuff. It's all handmade. My wife makes it out of all the bears that we take. But yeah, if you guys would support us, that would be fantastic. But the equipment that I used the Grim Reaper. Like I said, I was talking with, I think it's Matt Bateman from Grim Reaper. Great guy. Answered all my questions. I was going to use him for moose last fall. Had him on my arrows, but I didn't see a moose, so I couldn't shoot one. They performed great on this bear. And then the other piece of equipment was the DCA custom vanes. Super quiet. I used the, before that I used the AAE Max Hunters. Those are good. They really stabilize a broadhead, especially a fixed blade, but they're loud. These DCA custom vanes are super quiet. I've had some issues with adhesion, I'll be honest with that. I haven't tried them with a fixed blade, but super quiet arrow. You heard that in the video. It's not loud like the Max Hunters. I'll probably put a little video right now of just the comparison, but maybe I'll do a comparison video later this summer when I have nothing to do. But yeah, and then just the Revolt X, Bowtech Revolt X that I bought used. Yeah, I like the bow. So that's it. That's my 2023 bear hunt. Noah's up next, hopefully. So catch you guys on the next one.
Sadness with your rain boots and blue. Since I can remember, I've been running from you. But this time you sat your ass down with no intent to move. You ain't no
gorilla bear.
Well, the longer that you sit here looking into my eyes, the shock of your arrival begins to subside, and as I drop my defenses, you start to crack a smile. Are you a been proud and looking in a mirror that's clouded, smoke that's been keeping me shrouded, believing I'm fine, but you wipe clean all of these illusions that ain't me. Now you got me looking and I hate me. Where is my spine? Told me I'm only here to reveal where you've been stuck and where you're going if you're looking to heal. But you've got to drop these vain addictions and hang on to what's shadow. Instead of taking everyone to battle, climbing back up into the saddle. And now I stand tall. Used to think my sorrow was a brick wall. Made me want to curl up in a tight ball. Self-pity.